an AMI-TV digital exclusive.
I'm Mary Mammoliti, and this is A Taste of the Prairies. I have had such an amazing time in the prairies, but before I head back home, I wanted to use some of the artisan and farmer products that I found along the way in my recipes. I'm in the Get Cooking Kitchen in Edmonton, Alberta, Edmonton's best kept secret. They've been kind enough to allow me to use their kitchen as my own. So, let's get cooking. We're making some blueberry cricket scones today. So I want to start off with a large bowl placed right in front of me and several smaller bowls filled with pre-measured ingredients. I want to start off with our flour. So we've got 2 cups of flour that I'm going to place into the bowl. And once I pour that in, so what we're doing is we're getting all the dry ingredients in one bowl. 1/4 cup of granulated sugar, pouring that in. Next, we're gonna go to our secret ingredient, the cricket powder, which I've measured out into 1/4 cup. Pour that in. 1/2 teaspoon of salt, and we're adding 2 teaspoons of baking powder. Once we've done that, we're gonna grab a fork and mix up all your dry ingredients. You wanna get it incorporated. We're gonna move on. Now, leave the bowl where it is and just move over to the side, and we're gonna use a medium-sized bowl to get your wet ingredients ready. So I've got a medium-sized bowl in front of me. I've pre-measured out 3/4 cup of heavy whipped cream, but I want that chilled. So we're gonna pour it into the bowl. We're adding in 1 egg at room temperature, 2 teaspoons of vanilla extract. Get yourself your fork again, and we're gonna mix this until it's incorporated. This is actually one of my favorite parts because it's just so relaxing. Okay, we've got that all mixed in. We're gonna move back over to our dry ingredients. We're gonna add 6 tablespoons of chilled, cubed, unsalted butter to our flour mixture. I'm gonna just grab my fork, get that all in. While I'm here, let me grab my pastry cutter, and right in, you're gonna place the pastry cutter into the bowl and just chop up that butter into the flour. This is a great stress reliever. You can actually feel it. If you move the pastry chopper around your bowl, you'll feel as the chunks of butter start breaking down. But you want those chunks to still be like a little lumpy. Okay, we've done that, set this aside. We're gonna add now 1 cup of fresh blueberries into the flour mixture. Pour that in. And we've got 3 tablespoons of lemon zest. We're adding that into the blueberry, flour, and butter mixture. We're just gonna give it a quick toss to coat all the blueberries and spread that lemon zest throughout the flour and butter mixture. Now it's time to get our wet ingredients. We're gonna mix our wet into our dry. Grab your medium-sized bowl. So I'm gonna pour that into our flour mixture. Mix all your ingredients together now. So you've got your wet and your dry combined, and we're gonna form a dough. Once it gets to that point where you feel that you can't really use the fork any longer, but you still have a bit of flour left over, turn it over onto your prep surface, your countertop, your cutting board, whatever you're using, and get your hands involved. Get your hands in there nice and dirty. You're gonna set the bowl aside, get that out of the way. You want a clean surface, move everything. You don't need anything else but your dough right now. Okay, so we're gonna pour this onto our cutting board in front of us. Get everything out of there. Now I want you to run your hand along the bowl on each side, the bottom, make sure everything is onto the cutting board. All I want you to do is just take both hands, squeeze the dough together. Gently, we're not making jam, we're making scones. Bring everything into the center. So go from the outside in and squeeze. Give a little swipe around the perimeter. Once you're bringing it together, you want to lift this slightly just to make sure that you're capturing and incorporating all the flour that's directly below it, underneath your ball of dough. And what I want you to do is just form it into a big ball in the center. And I want you to take both of your hands, put them over top, and gently press down. You want it to be about, I'd say maybe 2 inches thick. Use one hand to press down the top and the other to form the sides of the dough. Get your cookie cutter, push that down. Start forming your scones. You're gonna get about 7 to 8, and it forms a little circle. And you formed your first scone. Take that, a rimmed lined baking sheet. We're gonna line that with parchment paper, which is what we've already pre-done here. I make it easier. I prepare everything. I get everything ready prior to. So this way, while I'm cooking, I don't have to fuss. Everything's in front of me and I don't have to search for everything. So place your first scone down on the pan. We're gonna cut this into about 8 scones. Now they're ready to bake. Pop them in the oven at 400 degrees Fahrenheit for about 16 minutes. Okay, so my favorite part, this is the moment of truth. We're gonna taste our blueberry lemon cricket scones. Let's see if I nailed it. Okay, this recipe is a keeper. And the bonus part, chocolate protein.
Stream more original content using the AMI TV app.